this camera wasn't active.
Apologies, just some technical sound issues. We're back. As I said, you're very, very welcome to this evening session of the European Mixed Team Championship qualification from Group 6 here in the Baldoyle Badminton Centre in Dublin. It's Ireland in green nearest the camera. Mixed doubles on the court against Slovakia in red, represented by Maciej Kilichan and Martina Rapiska. Of course, Ireland represented McGee siblings, Sam and Chloe. Pretty much as expected, Ireland lineup here this evening. Only change from yesterday is the introduction of young Sarah Boyle and Rachel Darra of women's doubles, placing Sinead Chambers and Jenny King. The surprise from the Slovakian lineup is the omission of Martina Rapiska at women's singles. Martina, as you can see, on court right now in the mixed, but also playing the women's doubles in the last match. Very focused, determined Irish team. A good smash winner cross court right into the body of Rapiska. Sam McGee. Excellent return of serve. Matchup. Kilichan. Placement. Sam. A really good start to this first match in this tie between Ireland and Slovakia. 10 unanswered points on the serve of Chloe McGee. Clever serve out wide from Chloe. And the Irish pair race into an 11-love lead. Ooh, difficult one to say that. Positive start, of course, the McGee's backbone of the Irish international badminton team. Sam and Chloe. Chloe playing mixed also. And also Joshua, the younger brother, playing men's doubles with Sam. When you have also Scott Evans on the team, who's playing so well of late. Bitburger Open finalist last week, winner of the Brazil Grand Prix.
20 seconds.
Night before last, had a convincing win over Hans Christian Vittinghus, world number 9 in the Danish league. So Evans really on the crest of a wave at the moment. Ireland, of course, favourites for this group. An expected group shootout match against Bulgaria tomorrow. Good angle, good smash, good combination. Sam. First point on the board for the Slovakians. Resolute in defense. Relentless attack from Ireland. Certainly very obvious. The Irish heading off to Asia straight after this tournament, actually. Super Series to test their progress at the top level. Players. And a regular mixed doubles partnership, of course, so you're going to get these regular mix-ups on court. A little bit of chemistry missing between them, for sure. You can see it on the court. The Irish so used to it. They're not only siblings, they've been playing together for so long in mixed doubles. Better than you can. Good flat drive cross court on the backhand side. Reception from Sam McGee. Soft block drop and a power smash down the middle. Good defense from the Slovakians. And the pull cross court at the net from Maciej just outside the tram line. Wide. Slovakians just struggling to match the pace of the Irish right now. Just finding the line. 19-2. It's time to serve out wide. Landing out. Important now for Martina just to get a run of points on her serve, get a few rallies going, try and get some momentum going into the next game. Who played in singles yesterday from memory. Looks like a promising singles player for sure. Struggling a little bit with the pace of this mixed doubles at the moment.
Service over, 4-20.
First real error from the Irish.
Game.
And things just going from bad to worse for the Slovakians. What a way to lose the game. Pretty bad up to that, of course. hand the game to your opponents with a serve into the net is not what they would have wanted. Everything going according to plan right now for the Irish. Confident start, Sam and Chloe McGee. Things just not happening for the Slovakians. Let's see what they can do. It's important for the Slovakian pair to come out in the second game and put some pressure onto the Irish. You're not going to win mixed doubles matches by standing back and defending. You're going to have to find a way of getting on the offensive. Chan. Good push. Chloe right into the body. Mache. This is the start Slovakians needed to prevent. Everything going the Irish way. Look at the net court. Crowd in here to watch this match.
Service over. Excuse me. Three love.
Looking forlornly at the line judge as he called it in. She called it in, my apologies. Again, another one finding the line. As they did in the first, the Irish are doing to the Slovakians in the second, stamping their authority on this game very early on. Big serve, variation. Chloe, flying smash, Sam McGee. Three quarter smash down the middle for a winner. Slovakians are looking at each other, really have no plan B here. Clever serve right over the head. Mache, no way. Athena can swing a racket at that. Not without beheading her partner, but
seven love.
Team in red, looking lost. Heads and shoulders starting to hang. Shuttle up rather than get it coming down. Carbon copy, 10 love lead. A bit of heavy, a little bit of strapping on the right knee of Chloe McGee. Eagle-eyed. Having some fans out there. Heavy schedule.
Service over, 11-1.
Chloe McGee recently, Denmark, France, a bit further. Lead. National Badminton League for Nottingham University on Monday night just gone, so schedule. Just starting to feel the effects of that schedule, I think, Chloe. Well in control here. 11-1 ahead, the Irish. Back out on the court rather quickly again, ready to go.
Ask. Level one, play.
As in the first, it's just vitally important that the Slovakians try and find some rhythm. Both players have to come back on the court again later. Both the men's doubles and the women's doubles. Super smash across the body of Sam McGee. Better shot that time from Mathieu. Isolated. Miscommunication between. But essentially are two singles players playing mixed doubles. Both just looking a little bit lost on the court. Against the mixed doubles specialist. Good defense from Martina. Better. In the rally now, the Slovakians. How can they get on the attack? Too short. Way too short. Easy. Sam McGee spotting the space at the front. Nice little soft drop. Maciej always stretching. But a better rally from the Slovakians. Traffic. From the rear court. Flat drive. I think it was supposed to be a smash from Chloe. Likely missed time. That from Chloe McGee, very uncharacteristic.
4-18.
Irish still have to go and win this. Power from Sam and the Slovakians just unable to cope with that power.
Nineteen.
communication between the Slovaks. Match point for the Irish. That's it. Convincing win for Sam and Chloe McGee. Not much the Slovakians can do about it. Two sets to love. Ireland get the best start. We'll be back shortly in interview with Sam and Chloe. And next match on court then will be men's singles. Scott Evans against Yaolem Vincent. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Slovakia, representing Jan Vincent. Have a moment. On my left, Ivan, representing Scott Ellis.
You're very welcome back. It's men's singles time. In green, furthest from the camera, Scott Evans of Ireland, nearest the camera. In red for Slovakia, Jarol and Vincent with his trademark headband, harping back to the days when he had long hair. And Evans, who has been in sparkling form around Europe in recent months and abroad, of course, winning the Brazil Grand Prix. Runner-up in Bitburger Open last week. Victorious over Hans Christian Vittinghus, world number 9 in the Danish league, only on Monday night, gone. Scott not happy with that line call. Oh, I think the line may have just got it right. These met before in the recent past, actually, at the European Men's Team Championship in Basel earlier in the year. Scott took 3 sets to get over Jarol. Scott won the first 21-19 and Vincent took the second 21-7 before Evans really struck out and cruised home lost the second 22-20 and won the third 21-7. So memories of a close match, but Evans has since upped his game. Really improved his defense in recent months. This judgment again from Scott, that one landing on the line. Angle on the backhand side of Jarol and Vincent on the smash from Evans. See it in the replay. Jarol almost beating it out. Good rally from the Slovakian. Having a strong umpire, felt that one may have caught the line. Level quality line judging this weekend here. Group 6 of this European Mixed Team Championship qualification. wild smash from Vincent. Outside the doubles tram line, almost out on the blue carpet. Flick serve from Evans. Patient rally that time from Vincent. He's holding, watching Evans. Scott look to be coming forward, and then Yarolem just pushing it back to the deep forehand side. That cross net, a long way out. Interval lead, Scott Evans, 11-9. Net from Evans. Oh! And a little bit of luck. Look at it in the replay. Evans went for the simple net kill. Yarrow sticks out his racket. And you see that so often in top level doubles or singles. Top level badminton. And an apologetic racket in the air from Yarrow. Getting lucky. Surely players at this stage should always know when you have an opportunity like that, just kill it hard down onto the floor. To Scott's credit, no argument whatsoever. Realized he made the mistake. And that's a good angle smash down the forehand side for the winner. Return of serve from Evans. Nice around the head cross court drop from Vincent. Very much, sir. A bow from Yarolen. Single point lead for Evans, 13-12. Good net from both men. Vincent playing some good badminton, playing quite confidently. Quite happy to take Evans on at the net. That's an area that Scott has really improved over the last year. His defense, you'll see it here once and twice. Yarolim really should have put that one away. probably not suspecting Evans would get the second smash back. Beautiful net spin from Scott. Oh, completely missed time smash on the forehand side. If you could call it a smash, didn't come off the sweet spot on the racket, that's for sure. Weak net shot that time from Evans. Too much air on the shuttle. Easy for Vincent to pounce. Evans watching that one the whole way, drift that over the tram line. Whew, lucky it didn't hit him. That's a few poor rallies from Jarol and Vincent. Again, this is something that sometimes lets Jarol him down. Plays so well for the majority of a set that it has these gross lapses in concentration. This time, perfect length from the Slovakian. Decision. Vincent certainly looked to be going out, and I think he knows it. It's close. Net result, Scott Evans has 4 game points. Takes it at first time of asking. First game to Scott Evans, 21-16. Second game, Scott Evans just taking on some sustenance. Sustenance even. in the mid-game interval. Banana down the neck. Defense from Yarolim, but equally good concentration from Evans. A nice textbook backhand net kill. Scott Evans after controlling the rally. Clever play. Pushing Vincent down the backhand side and following it up with a smash winner. Down that same backhand side. It's just bearing the serve, going out wide. Again, great net by the Irishman. Service fault of the weekend, from my memory. Service fault on the flick from Scott Evans. Setting up the attack. Such an important foundation stone of his game in recent months, that strong defense. Shuttle actually hitting him anyway, even if it landed out. Still a foul coming off the body of the Irishman. 6-all, very much following the same pattern as the first game did. That's a better angle on the cross-court smash, just out of reach of Evans's racket. Opportunity for Yarol and Vincent. And a poor lift from Vincent, easily put away by Scott Evans. beautiful net again by Evans. Evans, who races to an 11-7 interval lead. After a good start again from Vincent, it's Evans who just puts a little bit of daylight between himself and his opponent at a crucial point. One game up, Scott Evans leading 11-7. A little conscious of the last time these two met the European Men's Team Championships in Basel. Vincent took the Irishman for three games. Certainly a big few points now for Jarl and Vincent. Has to put some pressure on Scott Evans. Can't afford to let the Irishman get any further ahead. That's a good way to come out just after the interval. Shuttle psyching going on, become a traditional part of badminton, professional game, using a shuttle change to psych out your opponent. Super net shot, no chance for Evans. Stop net shot, Vincent. Frustration on the face of Evans as he turned back to face the camera. This is exactly what Jarl and Vincent needed and wanted after the interval. Good shot, Evans. Putting the shuttle in over the space behind Vincent. Shake of the head from Tom Reedy, the coach also. I think justice was done. Certainly Jarl and Vincent control that rally from the outset. Certainly. No argument about how wide that one was out. Change of shuttle required. You can just see a little bit of frustration coming in for the body language of Scott Evans. Riding the crest of a wave recently, winning, breathe, confidence, of course. The measure of the really good players is how they deal with the emotion of being down or losing. That's a better smash down the line. It's a real measure of the character of Evans. Poor shot from Yarolim. Even worse from Evans. Chat from Evans to the line judge. Saying to the line judge, I'm not sure if I should repeat it, but certainly saying to the line judge, how are you supposed to call the line? You can't even see where you need to mop. It'll be a fair point, in reality. Should be watching the game. Business end of this second game. Yeah. All of a sudden in that rally you could see Evans picking up the pace, marked increase in tempo. Scott just at the moment battling with himself more than his opponent. Scott's going to get a Christmas card off that line judge for sure. Very stop start second game. No real rhythm or flow. All he had to do was make the routine kill at the net. It's Evans' get out of jail card used in this second game. Great defense again for the Irishman. Good lift. Deep lift. There's a defensive. Followed by the lift. The error, Vincent. This is trademark Yarolim, I think. I've seen it so many times, play so well and then have 4 or 5 point lapse in concentration and you just can't do it at this top level. Be punished. Evans punishing him right now. That's a settling point for the Slovakian. Match point, of course. Oh, beautiful shot, and that's it. A way to end the match. Evans, a classic Evans. The job done. 2 sets to love. Next match on court, followed by an interview first with Scott. But next match will be women's singles. Chloe McGee against Jana Cisnarova.
Scott, many congratulations, and
think it's fair to say not vintage Scott Adams, but you've come through and you've won, and it's still a very important point.
Yes, today was probably the worst game I've played in the last 6 months, but still struggling with a little bit of energy, and apologise to the people that came out to see you play today. It's not the best. Hopefully you can go again tomorrow and pick up the performance.
We could see you as commentating on, and you could see you battling a little bit with yourself mentally more than your opponent. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I think it's just I've had the last 2 weeks have been very tough. Had a good result in Bitburger and then had to fly back Monday straight to a team match. Train Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, another team match, and then fly here Friday morning. So I think just the tough day yesterday, I'm struggling a little bit today, but tomorrow should be okay.
Scott, many thanks for joining us. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Scott Evans.
Representing Ireland, Chloe McGee.
Welcome back. Women's singles time, third match of five. Nearest the camera. In green for Ireland, Chloe McGee. Against Jana Sisnarova for Slovakia in red. McGee, hot favourite for this women's singles. Sisnarova taking over at singles duty from Martina Repiska. Repiska applying her trade in this match against Ireland at doubles and mixed doubles, already beaten in the mixed doubles. And a good start for the Slovakian, two love up. Five quick points in a row for McGee. Good deception from Chloe. After an early flourish from Jana Sisnarova, winning the first 2 points, it's Chloe McGee who's bounced back with 7 on the trot. Well left by Chloe. Those of you that may have just joined us late, Ireland 2-0 up, courtesy of Sam McGee and Chloe McGee in the mixed doubles, and Scott Evans winning a scrappy men's singles. Beautiful cross net from McGee, looking confident. Poor serve. The makings of a better rally for Sisnarova, and then letting herself down with the around the head cross court drop. But it's McGee who leads at the interval. 11-3. McGee in the ascendancy. Beautiful cross-court clip for the winner from Chloe. Nice stick smash from McGee. And again, that stick smash followed by the cross net. Better rally from Cisnerova. Rallies from Cisnerova. Beautiful, clear. Backhand corner. That over the tram line. So, this first game, Irish number one. Game point. That's it, first game. The jumped interception. 21-6. After a shaky start, losing the first 2 points, Joey McGee bounces right back to take the first game. 21-6. Looking comfortable on court. Looking really to have an easy afternoon after winning mixed doubles. Convincing fashion. First game of this tie. Their test, of course, comes tomorrow for Ireland against Bulgaria and what will be a group decider. Thank you. Both players back on court. Ready to go.
Second game. Love all.
Called in, just clipped the line. Decent call again from the line judge. We're not so convinced. Of this rally, Cisnerova moving McGee around the court. He's looking comfortable in defense, waiting for the opportunity. Oh, string gone mid rally. Slovakian smiling, I don't think she realized it. Acceleration from McGee, smash down the line. Oh, nice deception. Cisnerova. Power, slight frame. Even a net tail to sweep and a little bit of bite. A good rally, nonetheless, from the Slovakian.
Six.
decent start. Jana in this second game. Four in the mixed doubles, you can see. Slight strapping on the knee. Right knee, a lot of tournaments. Maybe get scheduled over the last few weeks. The winner. Big Burger straight home and went not even play in the English National Badminton League at home again. Next day training play this event. Getting out of Asia Super Series experience. Last rally, but it's to the lead 7-6. McGee already one set to the good. Ireland requiring this match to assure themselves of two wins in the group. They go through the group shootout with Area, who already won two matches. Chloe McGee leads, serving to Jana Cisnerova of Slovakia. Here it is, Slovak. Trying to tempo match the Irish number one for speed. Starting to go out of this match, very much one-way traffic in favour of the Irish number one. On her toes, racing forward to the net, pick the shuttle up. Easy afternoon so far. Chloe, easy victory in the mixed. A little bit of luck for Jana. and then court. Nice little block drop from the Slovakian. Angle into on the smash right into the body of the Slovakia. Wide open, full court. It's lacking a little bit of quality. Chloe McGee easy in the end, two sets to love. Battling performance from Cisnerova, Garland. Love. One on court. Move it. Doubles.
Some other results from around Europe, Spain beats Iceland 4-1, in Group 5 France, and at the Vinci 5-0 win over Belarus. The Czech Republic are leading 3-1 as we speak. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
very welcome back. The evening in green, Rachel Dara and Sarah Boyle, Irish juniors, their first senior international cap. Certainly they're going to remember the rest of their lives. More importantly, the grand scheme of things, 4-0 lead for Ireland. Just tie against Slovakia. The Irish settling point. Representing Slovakia, once again, it's Jana Cisnarova and Martina Piska. We've seen both of them in action already this afternoon. Very first big goals. Aided by Chloe McGee in the women's singles. Dara is, of course, niece of Chloe McGee, so keeping it in the McGee family once again. International. using all four corners of the court. Good vision that time from Jana. She's just out of reach. On a serve. The Irish take the interval lead 11-9. Dara. That a little bit, I think. Have a look at it. Certainly need to train or coach her out of that snatchy elbow into the side type technique. Stay concentrated. Nice bit of luck in the return serve from Sarah Boyle. Donegal woman. smash and reaching in two minds whether to take it or not. Lucky in the end, pulling the racket out of the way. Here. Out, yeah, and Sarah knows it. Good game point for the Irish. The Irish juniors, well played for Sarah and Rachel, really putting a lot of pressure on their opponents, and seeing over Martina Piszka, well worthy first game. For senior international, Dara and Boyle lead 1-0. Game. Thank you. operation, Dara. In the rally, locked in cross court. Need to get over. Reach Dara. Oh yes, beautiful. They fear. Slow back. Slovaks who get to the interval first, leading 11-9, the Irish one set to the good. Thank you. an Irish perspective. What was that run of points? Slovaks leading 16-12. Yeah, good rally. Smash across the body and then failing to find the line. Forehand side of Rakishka. Cisnerova looking good. Oh, and a very poor serve. Easily attacked. Rachel Lara. Boyle in particular. Good serve, but an equally good service return. Four-point lead. Slovakia. Rear court. In the end, strong defense. Cisnerova and Rakishka takes the Slovakians. Game point. Match in this tie to go the full distance, full three games, one game apiece. Good comeback. Cisnerova and Rapishka settle themselves after losing that first game. All to play for. Just as yesterday, women's doubles, after three games. the Irish girls beginning of this deciding set. New territory for the Irish air senior international. This is their first. Your opponents coming back to take the second. It's the pair who have won the second who go into the third with the momentum. Crucial. The Irish girls settle into this deciding game and keep playing their game. Here to do just that. And strong smash from Rachel Dara. Defensive too many, one defensive shot too many for Sarah Boyle. Game. certainly Kishka Sisnarova back in this match after winning the second. Class. Too many errors, really. Slovakians. Rally. Well played, Sarah Boyle. But Jean Aid is a healthy lead now for the Irish. This guy's in the flick serve from Rachel Dara. Decisiveness from the Irish. Smash down the line, landing out. Maintaining this 5-point advantage. Really getting towards all or nothing now. Slovakia. Yana Sisnarova coming forward. You'll see it here. A half a step forward, pushing the shuttle into the open space behind. There's a big smash from the small girl. Closer to this, their first win in their first match as seniors. She's going through the interception, is there to take. Slipping off the frame of the racket. Beautiful smash from Rachel. and a follow-up kill from Sarah.
Thank you. Thank you.